Chick-fil-A kickoff game here in Atlanta in its fourth season. Petersen, 61-5 as he enters his sixth season as head coach. Two Paul Bear Bryant Awards. He won the Bobby Dodd Award in Atlanta right here this past offseason. He's missing some important players. He'd like to have these three guys. With more on that, third member of our team, Holly Rowe. How?
Well, Boise State has decided to hold these three guys out of this game tonight while they review their eligibility with the NCAA. They're submitting paperwork, working with the Mountain West Conference to answer some questions. All three players came from the Netherlands to Boise to live. They're trying to get that result. They just weren't able to do it in time for this game tonight. Guys, this hurts them because, for example, Geraldo Boldevine was a wide receiver that mixed heavily in their rotation. He was the one guy they thought could really stretch the field for them. And maybe more importantly, their safety, Cedric Fabis, is a senior. He was experienced. And in his place is a redshirt freshman, Jeremy Ione. He is starting his first college football game in his life. Guys, we'll see how quickly Boise State is able to adjust and adapt without these three prominent players.
All right, Holly, thank you. Georgia won the toss. They want the football. That means Brandon Boykin, who about a week ago tweeted to Coach Petersen, "Coach Petersen, please kick it to me." Then he immediately called Mark Richt and said, "Coach, I might have done something wrong. I tweeted that I want him to kick me the football." Mark Richt said, "I'm not mad at you. Just go ahead and back it up."
Yeah. Well, he actually said, "I dare you." He might have told Coach Richt that he said, "Please kick it to me." But daring him to kick it to him is a little bit more putting yourself at risk.
Trevor Harmon, let's see if he kicks it to Brandon Boykin. Chick-fil-A kickoff game in Atlanta is underway. Kind of a knuckleball that Boykin is going to have to watch, hit 2 yards in the end zone, and he'll take a knee. So they sort of kicked it to him, and he lost a shoe in the process. So Georgia will go to work at their own 20-yard line. Aaron Murray set to come out as we take a look at our impact players brought to you by Chick-fil-A. Isaiah Crowell, the much-hyped and talked-about freshman. We'll see a lot of him at tailback tonight for the Dogs. Orson Charles probably will be the favorite target of Aaron Murray. They've been that way since high school. And on the defensive side of things and on special teams, we just mentioned him, Brandon Boykin, not only as a defensive back but a great returner, the all-time kick return leader in Georgia history, in fact. Richard Samuel, the veteran, will start in the backfield behind Aaron Murray. Georgia's first snap of the season, the Dogs from their own 20-yard line. And it's play action.
Yeah, movement though. Tight end move.
Justin Anderson. That's not the way you want to start the year.
79 offense, 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
So they back up to their 15-yard line. You work all spring. You lift weights on your own and you work out as a team without the coaches. Then you go through the preseason practices, all that anticipation.
Yeah.
You come up, you got a flag on the first play.
A little over-anxious by Big Justin.
Now it's Aaron Murray in the gun.
The key matchup, one of them in this game, the offensive line of Georgia against a very experienced and talented defensive front of Boise State. That's the strength of their team.
It's Samuel on a quick opening draw, and he only got a couple. Samuel, who moved the linebacker last year after starting his career as a Georgia tailback, and he is a load. Almost 245 pounder.
Well, he and Crowell will be a different type of runner for the Georgia offense. Samuel is going to be a north-south, lower that pads and be hard to tackle. Crowell, a little more shifty, make you miss kind of guy, whether he runs it or catches it.
Second down at 13. Murray, it's a quick toss and got it out to Tavares King. And King gets what he can, but it's not much. It's going to bring up third down and long. Of course, A.J. Green, Chris Humphreys are gone to the National Football League. And so the receiving core of Georgia is a little bit of experience there, but certainly not what they had in those two guys.
Our first big test for that receiving core and this new secondary. Holly mentioned the new safety, but they also had to replace three other starters coming into this season from last year's secondary.
Four receivers set on third down and 10. And again, movements. Everything moved with the ball. So not a good opening series so far for Georgia.
False start. 79. Offense. Penalty 5 yards. Remaining third down.
Well, Justin Anderson got the penalty, but I think that was really on the center, Ben Jones, because Justin wasn't the only guy that moved. But the ball was not snapped.
And now they're backed up to the 15-yard line again. Georgia was a 40% team on third down conversions last year, but certainly third and 15 is not how you want to open up the first quarter of the year.
And this is where Aaron Murray, as a sophomore, has to be smart with the ball. If it's not there, it's not bad to punt.
Murray fires deep middle. Had a man, actually. Orson Charles tried to tuck one in there, and Charles couldn't get to it. So a punting situation for Drew Butler. Georgia with a couple of penalties, and they'll be kicking deep in their own territory. This is a good guy to have, kicking deep in your own territory, though. Won the Ray Guide Award 2 years ago. Was a finalist for it last year. And he can really air it out. Average almost 45 yards a punt a season ago. But Drew's going to kick this one near his own goal line. Chris Potter is back deep on the other end.
Unusual look outside for Boise State, trying to confuse the punt team of Georgia on this first punt, and it's going to cause a clock violation.
Wow, three penalties on Georgia.
Delay the game on the offense. 5 yard penalty. Remains fourth down.
That's a worse spot for Drew Butler, because he's going to be in his own end zone to kick this one.
Georgia had two gunners outside, and Boise State started by looking like they were going to double cover both of the gunners, and then they started jockeying around like they were going to rush somebody from the outside, and it created confusion.
And the guy that's waiting on the other end is a good punt returner. Chris Potter averaged over 13 yards per return last season, and he should get a shot at this unless Drew Butler really blasts one. Potter waits at the 45. Across midfield, and he gets drilled immediately. But Kellen Moore and the Broncos will start their opening drive in Georgia territory. Let's take a look at tonight's impact players, brought to you by Chick-fil-A on the other side. For Boise State, Doug Martin, last year over 1,200 yards on the ground, and he is a workhorse. Tyler Shoemaker, with the top two receivers gone from a year ago, he's going to be a safety valve that I'm sure Kellen Moore will look at. And George Aloka in the secondary, going to be vital for him, missing one of their starting safeties to call the shots in the back end on defense for the Broncos. Kellen Moore and Boise State at the Georgia 49 with their first snap. And Martin's hit in the backfield. He's going to go down to the line of scrimmage. Swarming Georgia defense brings him down there. Alec Ogletree is there, along with Brandon Boykin.
I think how Georgia plays defense on first down will be critical in this ball game, because Kellen Moore, if they win first down and he's allowed to have the whole playbook on second and manageable situations, he'll pick them apart. That was a win for Georgia on the first down.
Kellen Moore on a pistol set here, in the gun with a tailback behind him. He'll give it to Martin. He sidestepped the first man. Not going to get away from the rest, though. Georgia drops him for a loss of two. And it's Boykin again.
The initial penetration by Jarvis Jones slowed up Martin and stopped his momentum. And that enabled Boykin to get there to make the tackle.
The Broncos, a very good team on third down a year ago. But as Todd said, usually they do much better on first and second down. They find themselves with third and 11. Georgia comes with an extra man. Moore deep down the middle, and it's knocked down by Boykin. Well, our impact player has been impactful in the opening series on defense for Georgia.
I think Georgia feels like their secondary people are athletic enough to really get up and try to disrupt the routes of the Boise State receivers. Their passing game is built on timing and not getting jammed at the line of scrimmage. And that time, Boykin able to get his hands on the receiver and disrupt the timing and knock the ball away.
Penalty marker down as Elkin comes in to kick.
Substitution infraction on the offense. Breaking the huddle with 12 players. 5 yard penalty.
So both teams a little shaky as far as the penalty markers and their opening offensive series. Brandon Smith is back deep for Georgia, and he is a sensational punt returner in his own right. Average over 14 yards of return last season. As you look behind, Brad Elkin. High snap. And the rugby-style punt to Chase Smith to the 11-yard line. Got by the first man and picked up about five to the 16. Travis Stanaway made the tackle. That was a good defensive series for Georgia to open things up, courtesy of Brandon Boykin. Dogs on offense when we come back. Donated $50,000 to the scholarship funds of Georgia and Boise State. Steve Robinson, Chief Marketing Officer of Chick-fil-A, presented the checks to President Custer from Boise State and President Adams from the University of Georgia. Chick-fil-A's long history of promoting education as they've awarded over $28 million in scholarships to college athletes. 11:49 remaining in the first quarter. You can almost hear the Georgia fans holding their breath in anticipation of this young man. The highly talented Isaiah Crowell is in the lineup for the Dogs for the first time in his college career. They fake it to him, and Murray will roll and throw, and a tough catch in traffic made by Marlon Brown. Good coverage, but Brown, big hands and a big body, was able to snatch that one and pick up some positive yardage.
Yeah, Marlon Brown is one of those guys they really expect to help fill in the gap for the loss of A.J. Green and Chris Durham, as we see Georgia now go to their version of a no huddle.
And Murray in the gun on second down at six at the 20. Crowell slips and falls. Yeah. That happens sometimes. So much for holding your breath in anticipation.
Just actually stepped on Aaron Murray's foot, I think, and that's how he lost his balance.
So he's got that one out of the way.
That's his mulligan for the night, right?
Exactly. It's third down and eight. Second time Georgia's been in a third and long situation after three penalties on their opening offensive possession.
So this is where Aaron Murray has to really pay attention to Crowell and keep him in form.
Murray fires incomplete. His receiver had fallen down. It was Orson Charles again.
Yeah, trying to go for Orson Charles again. He was expecting Orson to be outside, and he would have been open had he not slipped on his break.
So Drew Butler comes in again.
Well, so far for the Boise State defense, again, missing Cedric Fabus, replacing three key starters from last year, actually four defensive starters. Couple of nice jobs getting them off the field.
Three total series in the game so far, all three and outs, two by Georgia. Now Butler set to punt again. This time Mitch Burrows awaits on the other end for Boise State. Butler, he hit this one deep. At the 31, Burrows made the first man miss and the second. And he got out near the 39-yard line. Nifty little return after a 51-yard punt. Kellen Moore and the Bronco offense waiting in the wings on the other side. 10:35, first quarter, no score. ESPN from Atlanta, Georgia. The Boise State Broncos ranked number 5 in the country against the number 19 Georgia Bulldogs. Due to time constraints, we move ahead to further action. The SEC on ESPN. Georgia and Boise State, Kellen Moore on the line during our timeout. I'm sure talking to Brent Pease, the offensive coordinator, and the helmet's coming back on. I don't know, Todd, they're going to go for this thing?
Well, it sure looks like it. That's an offensive group in the huddle, not a punting group.
Here they come on fourth down and a long two.
It could be a quick kick as well.
Kellen Moore in an empty backfield on fourth down, unless they're trying to draw Georgia off. And now, timeout, Boise State.
Timeout, Boise State. That is their first charge timeout of this half.
So a little chess match going on here.
This will be a 30-second timeout.
Well, I was surprised that they lined up to go for it. I mean, that's a punt situation for sure at this point in the game. Neither offense generating anything. I think Chris Petersen was just seeing if he got a specific look that they might be able to get a gimme for the first down. They'd run the play otherwise, call timeout, and punt the football.
Now the helmet's off, so the punting team will come back out.
You got two offenses here that have both run six plays and gained 7 yards. So defensive struggle at this point.
Now Brandon Smith will trot back down near his own 15-yard line, awaiting the punt of Elkin. And again, Boise State spreads everything out.
You always have to be alert for a fake punt from Boise State.
Again, the side-winding punt. This one's going to roll down inside the 20. Boise State will down it there, and Georgia will have it back after a 35-yard punt. Well, ESPN wraps up the holiday weekend with an ACC battle Monday night. The Miami Hurricanes and the Terrapins of Maryland. And which new coach, Al Golden or Randy Edsall, can get their first ACC win in their debut with their new teams. College football primetime, part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week on ESPN. 8 o'clock Monday, also available in spectacular 3D. First two drives, that's not much, is it?
Yeah. Well, and all three of their possessions have started inside their own 20-yard line, so you got to be a little bit careful.
Richard Samuel back at tailback. And he'll get the call. And he only gets a yard, if that. That defensive front of the Broncos, I think it gets not enough attention, and yeah, probably overall their defense, because everybody talks about having a Heisman Trophy candidate quarterback. This defense is stout.
Well, they are. I mean, look at what they did last year now. They were second in the country in total defense and scoring defense to go with that prolific offense. And that front four right now, all four of those guys up there, both tackles and both ends, are seniors. They are a veteran, experienced group that has played a lot of big-time football for Boise State, and they're physical.
Second down and 9. Brandon Boykin in the lineup offensively, and here he comes to the corner, and Boykin into the secondary. This might be it. Goodbye, Brandon Boykin. Touchdown. For the score. He's already been a shining star on defense, and now he just lit up the Georgia crowd at the Dome with an 80-yard touchdown run. Blair Walsh for the extra point. 7-0 Georgia. We knew we'd see him on offense, Todd, and boy, did he explode on the scene.
Well, they've had trouble running inside against this physical Boise front, so let's run outside. And Bruce Figgins, who was a tight end last year, moved into fullback, and watch him lead this play and seal the corner for Boykin. It just takes one block. He gets a block on the safety, Iloka, and then Boykin uses that open field running ability to turn it into a touchdown.
Georgia's all-time kick return leader, and now the leader of the ground game of the Dogs, 80 yards for the score.
We have two current.
CC on ESPN from Atlanta, Georgia. The Boise State Broncos ranked number 5 in the country against the number 19 Georgia Bulldogs. Due to time constraints, we move ahead to further action. Sean Williams, starting safety for Georgia, down. He's one of the guys that ran into Doug Martin on the end of that run.
A little booing by the Boise section, thinking that that was to try to slow down this hurry-up offense. Shades of Cal and Oregon last year.
That's right. Well, Williams comes out. Meanwhile, Boise State's got a first down at the 30-yard line.
Good situation for play action pass right here. Now they've got some momentum. They've moved the ball down the field.
Two tight ends in. Burrows comes over to join the trio on the left side of Kellen Moore. A little bit of a play fake and fires down the middle. And what a strike that was to Tyler Shoemaker. Dive and catch. And now the Broncos got something moving. A 20-yard pickup. And we've got an injured Bronco down, the offensive lineman.
Well, it was out of a bunch set. Three receivers to the same side. And Shoemaker comes into the post. And again, that accuracy of putting the football where it needs to be, right in the middle of three Georgia defenders, but right where Shoemaker could make the catch.
Joe Kellogg, the left guard, got tangled up in some traffic. Trying to throw his block, and he's holding in the area of his left knee.
Joe Kellogg has had a great camp for Boise State. They felt that he had really come on and settled into that left guard position.
He was sort of engaged with the guy that he was blocking, and then one of the Georgia players sort of rolled up on him as they were trying to get pressure in the pocket. So they work on the left knee of the junior out of Scottsdale, Arizona. He'll come off, and Spencer Gerke will have to come in to take his spot. Meanwhile, it's right at the 10-yard line. So it's first and goal for the Broncos, trying to tie things up here.
I would say this is Doug Martin time again right here. In fact, he's the quarterback.
Yep, he's in the wild Bronco set, if you will. Fakes the handoff to Burrows, and he'll lose a couple. Christian Robinson, nice penetration for Georgia.
Christian Robinson is the quarterback of this defense. When we talked to Mark Richt, you know, where can you least afford an injury? He said it's a linebacker,
yeah.
And particularly that guy, because he is our quarterback. Makes all the calls, gets everybody lined up.
Kellen Moore back in. A bunch set of three wideouts to his right, and Martin will flush out of that backfield as well. Second down and goal. Moore, and Nate Potter, I think, came out of his stance a little bit early, so the Broncos are making it hard on themselves right here.
False start, 73 offense, 5-yard penalty remains, second down.
Well, we mentioned Titus Young and Austin Pettis, and for Kellen Moore last year, when he got in the red zone, he looked for Austin Pettis, and you can see 27 receptions, 22 touchdowns the last 2 years. That combination, that was his go-to guy in the red zone.
And you wonder who it'll be now. The biggest target is probably Kyle Efraw, his tight end. Second down and goal, but it's back at the 17-yard line. Moore waits and fires, and he's got his man, and it's a touchdown to Matt Miller. Nice throw and a 17-yard scoring toss. That's the 100th touchdown pass of Kellen Moore's brilliant career. Dan Goodale in for the point after. New kicker this year for Boise State. And he's got his first extra point up and good. Good looking drive by the Broncos.
Mitch Burrows is going to clear out to the outside. Matt Miller's going to sneak in right behind. And again, the accuracy of Kellen Moore, touchdown Broncos. Story, I mean, this is the first real football game he's played in since the Montana State High School Championship game in 2009. He was a versatile guy coming into Boise State. He tore his Achilles last summer, sat out the whole season with a red shirt, didn't go through spring, Kellen Moore told me on Tuesday when I was out there, he just started throwing to him 3 weeks ago.
Wow.
But he's very, very talented. And obviously, Kellen Moore gave him a good ball to catch.
So now it's Trevor Harmon to kick off. Brandon Boykin, Mr. Excitement, already in this first quarter, both on defense and offense. Back deep. This time he's going to get a shot at it. Boykin from the setting. And got across the 20. And not much more after about the 22-yard line. 16-yard return. So 2:55 remaining in the first quarter. And now we got things moving a little bit. Those first couple series was nothing but sputter on both sides.
A little nerves, a little over-anxious, you know, but now they've settled in. And like Kellen Moore, six different completions to six different guys, so he's spreading the football around. Now it's up to Aaron Murray, I think, to get going in his passing game. They got the score on a trick play. I expect him to look for Orson Charles in this drive, try to get the big tight end in the middle of the field.
Aaron Murray, who had over 3,000 yards in a sensational redshirt freshman season last year, but so far, a little rocky here in the first quarter. Isaiah Crowell. This time he keeps his balance, puts his hand down, and takes a tackler or two with him. Picked up five. That's his best carry of the night.
Pretty good hard-nosed run, too. I mean, you think he's just going to be a flash-and-dash kind of guy, but he can run with power. 215 pounds, 5'11", built kind of low to the ground.
Here he comes again. Crowell's got a first-down run. Picked up about six more. The helmet pops off, and now he's got the feel of college football. After coming out of Carver, Columbus, sensational career there. They could have used him last night. Buford put an on him in high school football last night. I guess when you lose a guy like that, it doesn't help your cause. Three straight carries. This time he runs into traffic, falls forward for a yard or so. Tyrone Crawford made the stop as we're down here 2 minutes in the first quarter.
And part of this hurry-up offense by Georgia, maybe the same philosophy, the same thinking as Boise State, try to tire out and put a little fatigue into this defensive front of Boise State.
Georgia looks to the sideline. They've got all three of their receivers to Aaron Murray's left. Second down and nine. Draw play to Crowell. Straight ahead, a yard, that's it. Chase Baker, part of that defensive front. He's had a good first quarter.
Well, he's the nose tackle. 6'1", close to 300 pounds, and he's got to just hold the point. You know, his job is to just eat up blocks and hold the point, and that's exactly what he did on that play.
Georgia again without a huddle. Samuel back in, flanking Aaron Murray. He's got four receivers on a third down and eight. Georgia's found themselves with a lot of third and longs here in the opening 14 minutes.
Boise State throwing, showing a three-man line, trying to give confusion to the blocking.
Murray fires the outs. Brown makes the catch. He broke a tackle, and he's got a first down, I think. That was great second effort by Marlon Brown. 6'5", 222-pounder. They knocked him to the sideline, but he kept his balance and got a first down.
Yeah, there was no way he was going to get the first down if he goes down right there. Hunter White, the nickelback, was not able to get him on the ground. And Marlon Brown uses that big body to get a critical first down for the Bulldogs.
They're so hoping that he becomes the next A.J. Green. They've been waiting on him. Only 13 catches in his first couple of seasons after being a highly recruited wide receiver. Samuel blasts the first would-be tackler, but then he's taken down. J.C. Percy's the first to hit him. And then Mike Atkinson finally put him on the turf.
Now, this Boise State team has 25 seniors this year, and 18 of those seniors are fifth-year guys. So they are mature, grown men who have won a lot of football games and played in some big ball games. So they are very comfortable in this atmosphere right now.
Murray again will backpedal into the shotgun. Seventh play of the Georgia drive, but they're going to have to wait until the second quarter begins. Dogs from the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. We'll move ahead to further action right after these messages.
invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich. And Chevrolet and their award-winning cars, trucks, and crossovers.
Boise State got about 7,500 tickets to this game. Those folks clad in blue. The Georgia Bulldogs have got the ball back. Their pro dog crowd asked for a play from the defense, and they got one from Brandon Smith on the interception. Now it's Isaiah Crowell on the carry out to the 23-yard line to pick up a five.
Well, Georgia's going to bring pressure from right here, and Kellen Moore is going to read man-to-man, but watch Brandon Smith. When this ball is thrown, his eyes are on the quarterback, and as soon as he sees him load up to go downfield, he leaves his coverage responsibility underneath and goes for the interception.
Georgia with a second down at five. Draw play to Crowell. Broke the first tackle, not the second, however. Nice play by George Iloka, one of our impact players.
I think Isaiah needs a new chin strap. That's the second time his lids come off.
Yeah. Either that or a tighter helmet. Last year, in his senior season at Carver Columbus, 1,700 yards and 18 touchdowns. Now he's in the big leagues. He's done a pretty good job after a couple of early missteps on his first couple of carries. Third down and three. Georgia with just under 4.5 minutes left in the quarter. Would like to keep this thing going, maybe get some more points before halftime. Murray fires on the sideline, and it is intercepted, picked off by Jarrell Gevins. So both quarterbacks make a mistake. Gevins gets it right back with good field position for the Broncos, and now they'll have plenty of time to try to make something happen before halftime.
One of the things you worry about with a freshman back is pass protection. He whiffed on the block, and that caused Aaron Murray to make a bad throw.
Their action. Martin's going to flush out of that backfield. So it's Kellen Moore. Firing on a slant, complete. Throws a dart to Matt Miller for another first down. Miller's the guy that caught the touchdown pass earlier in this half. Now they change up receivers and go again without a huddle. Georgia trying to change up some personnel on defense.
And Grant Hedrick is back in at quarterback. Again, he's the running quarterback. Kellen Moore's on the sideline. The last time he just handed off. Let's see if he doesn't try to keep the football on this time.
Out of Independence, Oregon, the redshirt freshman. D.J. Harper is behind him. He rides it to Harper and takes it on the sweep. And he's got a first down. So it pays off the Wildcat formation that time. A pickup of 11. Nice run.
Yep, and the key to that is to be patient with that fake, to carry it out at the mesh point and really sell it to the defense and not be in too big of a hurry to get it out on the perimeter.
So here the Broncos are in the red zone again, where they are very efficient. Last time they got it down to a first and goal, then lost some yardage, but still ended up with a 17-yard touchdown pass. Right now they've got it at the Georgia 11-yard line. Martin, the straight snap to him, and that hasn't paid off either time they tried it, as Georgia's waiting for it, a loss of one. Take a look at the red zone brought to you by Verizon. Last season, 47 touchdowns in their 68 possessions. Tonight, I mentioned earlier, one red zone possession, and it ended up with a touchdown pass.
And the last time Boise State lined up with three receivers over here, they came back to the single side receiver. Same action with the back out of the backfield.
They pump it that way. And now Moore down the middle to Ephraim. And he is in for the touchdown. The big fella took about three Bulldogs with him the last yard or so. We mentioned he's a big target down in that red zone. The last time they had it, this time they pay it off. The second touchdown pass for Kellen Moore. And Georgia player down again. I think it's Christian Robinson, the other inside linebacker. You talk about, we've mentioned it twice, Georgia couldn't afford to lose inside linebackers. That's their thinnest position. And this would be their second starter, and hopefully that's just a cramp again. The way they're treating him, you hope so, but.
Well, Kellen Moore is going to read this, and he's going to see two guys over here, two on one. So he's not going to throw that way. He's got four guys over here that he's going to work those four guys and just let that play unfold and pick the open guy. He sees the double coverage. He comes back the other way and finds Efaw underneath. And again, when you have a quarterback as savvy and as experienced as Kellen Moore, he reads that coverage. He knows where to go with the football right away. And then he gets it there on time and accurately.
They're taking a look at whether or not Efaw got in the end zone, but they say yes, and the extra point is up and good. So a big play first by the Bronco defense. The interception leads to the second touchdown toss of the night for Kellen Moore, and now Boise State in front by 7.
Sweat gear now available.
Let Celebrity Sweat take you to the next level.
Go to celebritysweat.net right now and grab your Celebrity Sweat gear and hit the gym today.
You don't want to miss this. Celebrity Sweat is hot. Now let's sweat it up.
You're watching the SEC on ESPN from Atlanta, Georgia. The Boise State Broncos, ranked number 5 in the country, against the number 19 Georgia Bulldogs. Due to time constraints, we move ahead to further action. From the 15. Aaron Murray does want to throw it. A screen pass. Got it to Samuel, but he only got a couple of yards. Mike Atkinson with the tackle.
Now, the story of the first half, to me, has been very clear. Boise State has been better in the trenches. Offensive line, defensive line, edge to Boise State. Therefore, they have the lead at this point going into halftime, and they'll get the ball to start the third quarter as well.
And Todd, if you think Isaiah Crowell isn't going to have to carry the load the rest of the way, Richard Samuel just limped off, and Georgia really only has two tailbacks, to be honest with you. Carlton Thomas not playing tonight due to a one-game suspension. The other two backs that carried the load last year both gone, and here is Crowell.
I think Mark Richt's got to get his guys in the locker room. And we talked about that edge that he has this year.
Yeah.
He's going to have to call on that edge and challenge the manhood of his offensive and defensive linemen, because they are getting whipped at the point of attack by the Boise State Broncos.
So a late interception by the Broncos here in the second quarter led to Kellen Moore's second touchdown. They had the lead at halftime, 14-7, as we get out of Holly.
Coach Petersen, it was a little slow in that first quarter trying to connect with your wide receivers. What started to change in this second quarter?
You know, these first games, you never know how it's going to go. There's not a lot of rhythm established at this point just because the game's played at a faster speed. We got some young guys. It'll take a minute.
What do you have to do a little different to establish the run a little bit better?
Yeah, there's no doubt we need to run the ball a little bit better, but hopefully our O-line can get into a rhythm as well, and hopefully the second half we click a little bit better on offense.
And you gave up the one long play on defense, but what else do you like that you've seen from your defense?
Well, I think they played well except for that one play, but that's the problem when you're playing a team like Georgia. One play and it can cost you big like it did.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, halftime. Boise State on the road, ranked 5th, leading number 19 Georgia, 14-7. Joined by Lee Corso, Kirk Herbst, Desmond Howard, David Pollack, and Aaron Andrews for a full hour of the latest news and happenings from college football. Then, from 10 a.m. to noon, game day moves to ESPN for 2 hours of features, inside analysis, and picks, getting you ready for all the day's action ahead. We'll have second half action from the Georgia Dome right after these messages. Got the lead heading into the third quarter, and they'll get the football first. Kellen Moore, a couple of touchdown passes. As you take a look at the statistics, so almost nothing offensive. Georgia, Todd, including terrible field position all night long.
They started in their own territory, and that 150 yards of total offense, a little misleading because they ran 30 plays. They got 80 in one play, so 71 yards on 29 plays is not very good.
Well, not only that, but the three positions that they were the thinnest, tailback, inside linebacker, and offensive line, and they've had three guys go down at each of those spots.
Yeah, they're going to have different guys step up, but those were the key areas that Mark Richt said they couldn't afford to lose guys. Take a look at Richard Samuel there trying to get stretched out. Had the quad injury that caused him to miss a couple weeks of practice coming into tonight's ball game. The other guys were Alec Ogletree, the sophomore linebacker, and the offensive guard, Kenarius Gates, who was one of their key guys on that offensive front.
The Boise State will get the football first, too, to start this third quarter. Remember, Jarrell Gavin's interception late in the second quarter led to Kellen Moore's second touchdown pass, and that's why they've got the one-score lead. Doug Martin's back deep, the starting tailback, as the kick return man. He'll field this one at about the one-yard line. Gets those high knees lifting as he got across the 20, out near the 24-yard line.
Well, this was Kellen Moore on their last scoring drive, and I want you to see two things. Number one, the accuracy of the football, and number two, no red jerseys around him when he throws the football. So good protection by that veteran offensive line, and if you give him time, he's going to pick you apart. And if you look at his pass charts, a left-handed quarterback, most of his damage done on the left side of the field, and mostly short, not throwing the ball down the field and hasn't really had to at this point.
He hit 9 of his last 10 pass attempts to close out the first half. Sets his team up at the 24-yard line to open the third quarter. Doug Martin trying to bounce it outside, and Georgia's defense is there to meet the challenge and dropping for a loss. Let's check in with Holly.
Checking in with Georgia coach Mark Richt at the half. He said that Kenarius Gates, their offensive lineman, is out for the game, but he said Dallas Lee is ready to go and should be a capable backup. But they have lost Alec Ogletree for the game, guys. That's a huge blow. It looks like Christian Robinson will be able to go. But Coach Richt said they've got to start making some plays downfield.
Trying to make one there to try to strip the ball out of Mitch Burrows, but he hangs on. Jeremy Sulik with the tackle.
Jeremy Sulik is the guy who's in there for the injured Ogletree. He's the other linebacker now playing alongside of Christian Robinson.
They had Herrera, the true freshman, in there at times, but Sulik has some experience, senior out of Decula. And it's a third down and a couple. Georgia changes up some defensive personnel. Kwame Gethers, the big nose tackle, hustles out there, number 99, trying to plug that middle. Third and two. Let's see if Martin gets the call. Nope, play fake. Moore over the middle, completes it. Miller's got a first down.
See, this is what makes Kellen Moore so good. I think this was a run play called, but they give him a pass option. Georgia tried to substitute big people anticipating a run. Kellen Moore saw that and checked to the pass and threw for the short first down instead of trying to run against the Georgia front.
So again, without a huddle, the Broncos and the Pistols set at the 40-yard line. Opening drive, third quarter. Moore going to the left side again. Efaw with the catch, but he's hit immediately by Sean Williams, the safety. Williams was shaken up earlier in the first half as well, but he's back out there. They haven't had to worry about huddles much tonight, have you?
I think a huddle is a thing of the past in college football.
Martin trying to test the left side, got a yard, that's it.
You know, you hear somebody describe a guy like Kellen Moore, say he's like a coach on the field. Well, part of that is his decision-making and his recognition. He doesn't allow Boise State to run bad plays. He sees what the defense is, and he makes sure he gets his team in good plays.
Third and five, zips another one complete and another first down. It's Mitch Burrows again. So just methodically slicing it down the field against the Georgia defense. Number 11 doing his thing. Moore again, complete again, and another first down. Kirby Moore's little brother with his first catch of the night. Well, little brother in age, not size. Again, they're hurrying it up here against the Georgia defense. Moore to his brother again, back-to-back catches. Out of bounds with a first down.
And you can see Georgia players tapping their heads. They need out. They need a rest. And that's exactly what this hurry-up offense that was made so popular by Oregon is doing. It's wearing out the defense, and they're not rushing the passer with much energy.
And this time.
And now they call a timeout. I mean, this is a desperate timeout. Defense.
Georgia, that is their first charge time out of this half.
Hoping to get some gas timeout back in the tank of the Dogs.
Health insurance update.
This just in for all uninsured Americans with or without.
DC battle Monday night for you. The Hurricanes and the Terrapins. Al Golden, Randy Edsel trying to earn a win in their ACC debut. College football brought to you by part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week. Monday, 8 o'clock on ESPN. Well, mostly Georgia fans here in a sold-out Georgia Dome tonight, but they have been disappointed in what they've seen so far. Their team down 14-7 and being forced to call a timeout because the Broncos were just moving it down the field at ease with their no-huddle sets. They've got it to the 24-yard line of Georgia right now. Moore under center. Fakes the end around and then lofts a pass to the sideline. He's got another first down. And it's Gabe Linehan, his other tight end.
Well, they are in rhythm right now. You know, when Chris Petersen told Holly at halftime, it takes a little while to get a rhythm in the first game, they're in rhythm right now. That's what this is. No pressure on Moore. They're just mixing and matching. He's throwing to a lot of different guys. I dare say this offense might be even more unpredictable than it was last year because there is no Pettis and there is no Young, and Kellen Moore just throws all over the place.
They've got it first and goal. Martin hit, a big hit. It caused a helmet to pop off. Loss on the play is Corey Moore. I beg your pardon, Jarvis Jones, the linebacker, made the stop.
The best thing that Georgia has done tonight defensively has stopped Doug Martin. I mean, here's Jarvis is going to come in crashing on the outside. It takes a good line to the football, and they've done a good job bottling up Doug Martin. But they've not done a good job getting consistent pressure on Kellen Moore in the passing game.
Now they got Harper and Martin in an eye set, both behind Kellen Moore. That's Efaw, the tight end in motion. Toss sweep to Martin, trying to get to the corner. Smith tried to get him but couldn't. Touchdown. 7 yards for Martin, so this time they don't bottle him up. And he skips outside and beat one of the better defenders for Georgia to the corner of the end zone.
We got a really nice block from his tackle, Nate Potter, and the tight end, Kyle Efaw. And then he just beat the last guy himself, Brandon Smith. Have trouble running inside, bounce it outside, and a touchdown for Boise State.
Boy, that was a good-looking drive. Took just under 4 minutes to go 76 yards. And they score on the ground for the first time tonight. So the fifth-ranked Broncos extend their lead courtesy of their star tailback. 21-7, Boise State.
Golf game brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's. And Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Broncos now with a 2-touchdown lead. And right now it's time for trivia question answer, which was Brandon Boykin, 4 career returns for touchdowns, tied with 2 other players in the SEC. Who were they? Willie Gault, the speedster from Tennessee, and more recently, Felix Jones of Arkansas, now with the Dallas Cowboys. Well, Georgia would love to see number 5 on the kick return for a score from Boykin because he's been the only offense so far tonight. He'll get a chance. Brandon will take it at the 1 yard line. And they've got him dialed in, and he almost lost the ball. Covered it himself at the 15. But there again, the starting field position is actually getting worse. We told you at one time, The average was the 18-yard line. It's going backwards, Todd.
Well, and this is a credit to Chris Petersen, too, because last year, one of the weaknesses of this team was the average starting field position for their opponents after a kickoff was the 32-yard line. Well, they have certainly improved on that tonight. And again, we see Georgia starting 85 yards away from their from the goal line.
Seventh start for the Bulldogs inside their own 20. And Aaron Murray has had a very, very tough night so far. Play action. And this throw is on the money to Orson Charles. Pickup of almost 12 and a first down.
And they went to the I formation play action pass because that's their best pass protection. That's a seven-man pass protection. They had trouble blocking this front of Boise State. Boise's not a blitzing team. They usually just bring four, maybe five guys at the quarterback. But that play action pass picks everybody up.
By the way, the big tailback, Richard Samuel, even though he was shaken up at the end of the second quarter, is back in there. They fake it to him, and Murray goes deep down the middle to Charles again, spins away into Bronco territory to the 45-yard line.
See, Boise State is rushing five. So Mark Richt's answer is to block with seven. See, they're going to bring five guys in here. And so Mark Richt says, we're going to go play action with two backs, and we're going to block with seven and give our quarterback some time to throw the football down the field.
At the 45, this time they do give it off to Samuel. And he got about three to the 42. Billy Wynn on the tackle.
This is a good change by Mike Bobo and Mark Richt, because if Boise State wants to commit five guys to the rush, and that only leaves six in coverage, and you can get three guys out for sure, and if maybe get a back out to get a fourth receiver out. But you do it primarily for protection first to give Aaron Murray some time.
The second and seven is only the sixth play that Georgia has run in Boise State territory tonight. Nice play fake, and Murray loads and fires again complete. This time it's Aaron White, his other tight end. Pick up a 14. All of a sudden, life in the Georgia offense and in the dome itself. Got it down to the 28-yard line. And again, both teams, for the most part, no huddle tonight.
See, now this is where Aaron Murray has to realize Isaiah Crowell is not really up to speed on all the pass blocking. So I got to make sure he knows exactly what he's doing when he's next to me.
Took off too fast, but so did Cordy Glenn, I think, the left tackle.
False start, 71 offense, 5-yard penalty remains first down.
It's a fourth pre-snap penalty on Georgia, this time on their left tackle.
Last year, Aaron Murray, when he threw the ball down the field, he was much more effective with play action faking than he was with no play action. And again, first and foremost, the reason for that is it's better protection.
Now they got a long yardage situation on first down. First and 15. Under 9 minutes in the third quarter. Georgia trailing by two touchdowns. Isaiah Crowell with a blocker in front. Nifty move to the inside. And now goes down at the 30. Only got three out of it. Darrell Gavins, who has one of the big plays of the night for the Boise State defense, made the tackle. Gavins had that interception, if you didn't see it, late in the second quarter that led to the Kellen Moore touchdown pass that put him up by seven at the break. At the 30-yard line, Georgia taking their time here, but again without a huddle as Aaron Murray, their sophomore quarterback, lines him up. He's moved this from his own 15-yard line down to the 30. That's Mitchell in motion. Here comes some extra pressure. Murray fires to the outside and incomplete. Tavares King couldn't handle it. That wasn't the best throw of Murray's night. Deep out on the right side, and King just couldn't quite get to it cleanly. Now here's the problem they've had all night, other than bad field position, bad third down situations for Mark Richt and the Georgia offense.
And you see Crowell is out and Samuel is back in because he's a little more experienced, maybe in a bigger body for pass protection.
They've got to get it down to the 18-yard line for a first down. At least in this situation, with an excellent kicker, if nothing goes wrong, they should be able to at least try to get some points here on this drive.
Orson Charles is in the slot.
Murray pump fakes. Not enough time for a double move and a pump and then a throw, and he goes down. And now that is probably going to take him out of what I was talking about. Field goal position, third sack of the night.
Just a five-man pressure, and they were able to get to Aaron Murray. Again, this is a team that led the nation in sacks last year with 49. It's not an all-out blitz with zero coverage. It's just five guys rushing.
Well, one of the best kickers in the country. He's never hit one this far in a game. Practice maybe, but his career long is 53 for Blair Walsh. He'll try from 55 yards out and on the way, and it's wide left. Georgia had a great thing going and came up empty. Boise State will get the ball back with a two-touchdown lead here in the third quarter with 7:21 remaining. Jr. battling for their postseason lives, plus with $3 million on the line in the Sprint Summer Showdown. Drivers are going to do anything to win. NASCAR Sprint Cup Series is here in Atlanta, presented by Pennzoil. Coverage starts on ESPN tomorrow night at 6:30 Eastern Time. Brian Scott, who is driving the Boise State blue number 11 car, finished 12th, but I'm sure he was in 11th place at some point tonight. At the 37-yard line, first down after the missed field goal by Blair Walsh. Kellen Moore off the play fake on the bootleg, throws to Efall, the tight end of the 40. Picked up of about four.
Well, for Kellen Moore now, that's 17 of his last 18 he's completed.
The other one was an interception.
Yeah, and we've mentioned he lost two guys in Austin Pettis and Titus Young that each caught 71 balls last year.
This time he whips it out on a screen pass to Burroughs. And Burrow's got about three more.
And they left home, as we reported at the beginning of the game, Geraldo Boldevine, who was considered to be their big play receiver this year, coming back. So what he's doing tonight with guys who don't have much experience is pretty remarkable.
Sure is. Third and three. He's got another completion, but this time Georgia is going to drag the receiver out of bounds. Jeremy Sulik with DJ Harper. Drags him out short of the first down.
That was really a big stop by the Georgia defense.
Yep.
They needed that. They needed to stop the bleeding somehow. And now hope that maybe Brandon Smith can get him some decent field position for Aaron Murray in the offense.
Brad Elkin in the punt. There is Brandon Smith hustling back. He's got an interception tonight. His teammate in the secondary, Brandon Morgan, has the only Georgia touchdown on an 80-yard touchdown run. Again, they keep it away from Brandon Smith, but this one shanked out of bounds over there about the 25-yard line. Well, 6 years ago, these two teams got together. That one was in Athens, and DJ Shockley had the game of his life. Six touchdowns for DJ, including that one on the ground, five through the air. Jared Zabransky had a horrible game. Six turnovers, four interceptions, two fumbles, and then DJ went to the air. Touchdown pass to Sean Bailey. Final score 48-13, and boy, would they like to have some of those points right now.
You know, Chris Petersen was the offensive coordinator on the staff at that time under Dan Hawkins, and he said two things stood out in 05. They had way more team speed overall than we did, and the humidity playing during the day in Athens was unbearable for our team.
This is the best starting field position of the night, if you can believe that, for Georgia at the 25. Quick play fake. Murray's going to load and go deep. And he overshot everybody, including his intended receiver, Rontavius Wooten. Aaron Murray comes into the season as the SEC preseason choice to be the first team all-SEC quarterback, and he's looked anything but that tonight.
Well, credit goes to this Boise State defense. Again, they are solid. I mean, they were second in the country last year, total defense, scoring defense. They lost four guys that all went to NFL camps, and they don't seem to have missed a beat.
Figgins steps in front of Crowell to try to lead the way. And Crowell, the highly talented freshman, has been bottled up pretty much tonight. Pickup of three. Isaiah finding out this is not high school football anymore.
Well, there's Jared Zabransky, the quarterback in that fateful opening game in Athens. Boise State went on to a 9-4 record that year, kind of disappointing. But the next year, they went undefeated and beat Oklahoma in the Fiesta Bowl, yep. And that kind of put Boise State on the map. And Jared Zabransky said very clearly, if we wouldn't have gone through what we went through in Athens, we'd have never been ready to take that next step the next year.
Yeah, Jared ended up as a cover boy on EA Sports video game that year after the perfect season. Murray in the pocket, flushed out of it, and downed again. Billy Wynn gets him this time.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised with Aaron Murray right now because he should know that he can't hold the ball as long as he's holding the football. I mean, he plays in the SEC. They have fast defensive linemen week in and week out in the SEC, and he's holding the ball too long. If it's not there, you got to throw the football away and not put yourself in bad situations.
Drew Butler to punt. Nice kick. Back to the 23-yard line to Potter. Potter got a block across the 35. Chris Potter into Georgia territory. Got another block, weaving his way all the way down inside the 30-yard line. A 56-yard punt, but a 44-yard return.
Well, we've seen Jarrell Gavins make a couple nice plays, including a big interception. He's also going to be the guy that gets the first block on this punt return. Watch Gavins circle back and get the first block that just allows Potter to get upfield, get his shoulders square, and see the defenders coming at him. You got to make the first guy miss, and Potter did that with a little assist from Jarrell Gavins.
We told you, Chris Potter averaged over 13 yards of punt return. That one good for 44. And now the Broncos have set up shop at the Georgia 28-yard line with a two-touchdown lead. Moore wants more. Sideline, just overshot Mitch Burrows.
One of the few times that Kellen Moore has ended up on his backside tonight, too. And I know what he's feeling right now. He's thinking the way our defense is playing, if we put another one in right here,
yeah,
we're going to be in great shape. I don't think this team can score three times against our defense.
They've got only one score, and that came on not necessarily a trick play, but by using their sensational cornerback and return man, Brandon Boykin, on an 80-yard touchdown run offensively. But the rest of the Knights belong to the Broncos. And here's Harper. And Harper broke free. And now a face mask going to be added to it as he goes to the 20-yard line. Brandon Smith got his hand in the mask. And it's going to be a big gainer for Boise State.
It's a bad job of tackling by the Georgia defense. They had Harper bottled up around the line of scrimmage, and nobody took him, wrapped him up and got him to the ground. And then they got a penalty on the end of the play.
This thing's going to take it down inside the 10-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask, number one on the defense, half the distance to the goal, first down.
Not only a good run by Harper, but as Todd said, shoddy tackling by Georgia, and then to add
here's
to the
two
problem.
Missed tackles, and,
yeah,
and then a penalty on the last tackle. I mean, that's not very good fundamental defense.
Grant Hedrick has come in again in a Wildcat formation as a quarterback. Line of scrimmage just outside the 10. So it's first and 10 at the 11. Hedrick had an 11-yard run the last time he touched it. This time he's going to bring it to the right. Hedrick to the 5 and run out of bounds there.
See, that's a designed run. And the reason I say that is because they got the tight end Efaw out blocking in front of him. I mean, the back is going out and Efaw is leading that play. Watch number 80 come and lead the play. As the quarterback gets the ball, he's following the block of Efaw out on the edge, and that's a good positive gain. The second time we've seen Grant Hedrick do that for the Boise State offense.
At the 4-yard line, it'll be second down and 3. Broncos threatening again. Harper in there at the tailback spot. He'll get the call. And Georgia wraps him up. Another helmet comes flying out and picked up a yard. They bring out third down and 2. And Georgia's absolutely got to have a stop here. As Todd said a couple minutes ago, this thing goes to 28-7. And There's going to be a lot of people filing out of the Georgia Dome. With a guy that has the leadership qualities of Kellen Moore, you don't just count on this being a run. This might be play action or a rollout, and you try to get another touchdown pass. There's the play action. There's the lob to the end zone for the touchdown to Tyler Shoemaker. Making it look that easy.
Well, again, I know I've said it a bunch of times, the accuracy of Kellen Moore, but he threads the needle on this one. I mean, there are three Georgia defenders, and Kellen Moore comes out of that fake and shoots it in between three guys for the Boise touchdown.
Remember, it was all set up by the great punt return by Potter, and the extra point is good. And everything is coming up roses right now for the Broncos. A third touchdown pass of the night for Kellen Moore as he slices the Georgia defense, and it's 28-7. ESPN from Atlanta, Georgia, the Boise State Broncos ranked number 5 in the country against the number 19 Georgia Bulldogs. Due to time constraints, we move ahead to further action. Second down, 11 at the Bronco 45 for Georgia. Murray, the play fake and the bootleg again, being chased, throws on the run and in and out of the hands of Tavares King. Should have had it, would have been a first down.
Yeah, that's got to be a catch. J.C. Percy was putting the pressure on Aaron Murray. He used his athleticism to get outside and then made a nice throw a little bit behind, but certainly a catchable pass.
So third down and long, which we've said many times tonight for Georgia.
Well, I think this is four down territory for Georgia, too. So Aaron Murray's got to be thinking here, you know, if it's not there for the first down, let's get at least half of it on this third down play.
Mitchell in motion. Now flags down. Making it harder and harder.
False start. 71 offense. 5-yard penalty remains. Third down.
It's Corley Glenn's second penalty of the night on a false start.
Well, the problem, again, for Georgia is that they've not been able to block this front. And now the game is right in the hands of the Boise defense because they're great at rushing the passer with just four guys. And they've got a 21-point lead. So they know they can really go after the passer and not worry too much about the running game of Georgia.
Might not be two down territory at midfield. Third and 16 for Georgia. Draw play. Crowell. Got to follow his blockers. Got it to the 42. That's fourth down. About 8. Nope. Well, there's some blue boobirds out now. That's what you don't want to hear as a head coach who had a 6-7 season last year in your season opener. So Drew Butler comes in to punt.
Well, right now you're counting on Drew Butler to be able to try to pin Boise State deep in their territory and hope that you can flip the field here because you got a whole quarter of football left.
Sure.
And right now you've got to hope that your punter and your defense can come through with a great punt and a three and out.
Tending to Aaron Tavis out on the field right now, the linebacker for Boise State.
You know, Brad, when I went out to Boise on Tuesday and I saw them on the practice field, and I hadn't seen them in person, I was impressed. I thought physically they were much bigger and stronger and physical looking than I thought they would be. And I would go so far as to say I was at the championship game last year with Auburn and Oregon down on the field, and I think Boise State looks every bit as physical as Oregon to me, who played in the national championship game. They may not be as big man-for-man as an SEC team, but they were as big as the team that played for the national championship last year in Oregon.
They're living up to their number 5 ranking right now, that's for sure. Butler. Have an end over end job, and it will force a fair catch inside the 10 of the 8-yard line by Mitch Burrows. There's a penalty marker down, actually, and it's going to be offside. I wonder if this changes things. Offside on Boise State. That was on a fourth down and about eight, huh? That makes it fourth down and two or three. Does Georgia go back on the field and say, let's take a crack at this thing? I mean, this might change things a lot.
It sure could.
Offside, number 15 of the receiving team. 5-yard penalty remains, fourth down.
Yep. Aaron Murray back on the field. The offense back on the field.
Here we go. And we said four down territory. That was about four plays ago, but just some strange circumstances that put us in this situation.
And if you're going to throw, if you're Aaron Murray, you better make sure Crowell knows his assignment, and you better not hold on to the football very long.
Big fourth down. Murray fires deep. Man open. Charles, touchdown. Yards to who has been his favorite target since high school, Orson Charles. Whoa, what a difference a penalty makes, huh?
Well, that's what's called getting frozen if you're a safety. Travis Stanaway was totally frozen.
Extra point is good. And what looked like a dead dog is very much alive right now. 1:19 remaining in the third quarter. And Georgia strikes following a big offside penalty. They go for it on fourth and short. And Aaron Murray hooks up with his favorite target for a touchdown.
Travis Stanaway is the safety who's in the ball game. All right? He's going to get frozen as Orson Charles runs the flag. Watch Stanaway just get flat-footed. And Charles is going to run right by him. Whoops. That's an easy throw for Aaron Murray. And again, the safety issues. Cedric Fabus not here. His backup, Jeremy Ione, is out of the game right now. They're into their third safety in Travis Stanaway, and it cost him that time on fourth down.
Charles with the new do, matching the all red jerseys. And now that sideline that Holly was talking about was so quiet, there's some life.
And it all started with the kickoff return by Boykins.
Right.
You know, that got the energy going. And then the offense came through with a couple plays, and the key penalty on Boise State helped.
Blair Walsh with a kick. Martin at the three. Martin, good boy. He took a shot, but he did get it out on a 23-yard return. Now can number 11 come out, just quiet this Georgia crowd right back down again with his efficiency. And look at the efficiency. One misfire. Other than that, you can tell why he's got a great quarterback rating.
And, you know, coming into the game tonight, over the last two seasons, nobody has completed more passes of 20 yards or more than Kellen Moore. But he hasn't thrown the ball deep down the field tonight. It's been more nickel and dime and picking and choosing and some yards after the catch. But he hasn't missed the mark very much.
How can the Georgia defense make a play? Here's Harper. Harper eats out about 3 yards. It'll bring up second down at seven. There's Julie Moore, newlyweds, Kellen, and the former Julie Wilson. Got married in the offseason. Kellen also graduated with a degree in communications in May, so he's in grad school. It's a lot to handle. Grad school, football wife. You know, I don't know which one's harder or tougher. None of them are easy. Second down, eight. Georgia shifting defensively. Kellen Moore drops the throw over the middle again to a wide open Burrows. And he's got another first down. Let's check in with Holly.
The defenders are continuing to fall for the Georgia Bulldogs. Their nose tackle, Kwame Gathers, number 99, is over on the sideline. He's got a big ice pack up underneath his shoulder pads on his right shoulders. Guys, he's the man they were relying on to hold that point. So in his place, you see number 6, John Jenkins. He's a big man, but he is a JC transfer. This is his first football game at the Division I level. Let's see how he holds the point.
He's actually heavier than Kwame by a pound. 351 compared to 350.
He doesn't look as big with that number 6, though.
No, he doesn't.
The single-digit jersey. Not sure what he's going for there.
Trying to look slim.
That is the end of the first quarter.
End of 3. Boise State on the road. Georgia fans are hoping the fourth quarter brings them some magic. 28-14 Broncos. Against the number 19 Georgia Bulldogs. Due to time constraints, we move ahead to further action. Moore end around to Burroughs. Good run by Burroughs, who's been a big part of this offense tonight. He reminds me a little bit of a Wes Welker type of guy. He was all over the place.
You know, we've said so much about Kellen Moore and what he's done, but we should also tip our hat a little bit to Brent Peace, the offensive coordinator. In his first year, he's been the wide receiver coach here for the last 5 years, and he took over for Brian Harsin, who succeeded Chris Petersen as the offensive coordinator. There's Brent. And Harsin went to Texas, and Brent Peace went to Indiana for 5 days and then came back to be the coordinator here.
Hedrick again will hand it off this time to Harper, and no gain on this one. Avery Jones, made the stop. Time becoming a factor here with 12:35 remaining. Boise State's never beaten an SEC team. 0-4 against SEC opponents. Lost to Arkansas a couple of times. Georgia, we mentioned 6 years ago, and South Carolina. But that stuff was all 5 years or more. And they've won 61 games out of 66 since then. So you can put that stat to bed, I think, if you're an SEC fan. Because this team is all it's cracked up to be so far. And on this night, and now Harper on the way to the end zone. All the way to the 2.
Well, they really outflanked the Georgia defense that time. They brought motion with the tight end. They had both tight ends on that side of the field, both Efall and Linehan. They have big Nate Potter, number 73, their best offensive lineman over there, and they outnumbered the Georgia defense on that power sweep.
That's first and goal at the 1. After a 17-yard pickup. Moore with Harper to his right. We'll pitch it to him. Harper, easy walk to the end zone. Touchdown. And the Boise fans that made the trip from the west to the southeast are pretty happy right now.
Wow. Now that's an impressive answer by the Boise State Broncos. And if there's any question, are they legit? Are they in the upper echelon, the elite of college football? Absolutely.
76 more yards in 4:42. And they make it 35-14. Now Georgia has got a ton of work to do because the Broncos from Boise State are on their way to a big opening season win. The SEC on ESPN continues from the Georgia Dome in a minute. Remaining in the ball game after another 76-yard Boise State drive. Todd Grantham, the defensive coordinator over there, not that particular position, but he's on the sideline still trying to coach him up. But this is the most points Georgia's given up in a season opener in a long, long time. And they did such a great job in the first quarter, and then things started to explode on them. And you have to go back to 1974, the last time they gave up this many points in an opener. And that was against Oregon State. This is the highest-ranked team, in fact, Georgia's played in a season opener since 1965. But they beat defending champion Alabama in that one in Vince Dooley's second season. Doesn't look like that's going to occur here tonight unless there's some sort of miraculous comeback in the next 11 minutes and 37 seconds. Brandon Boykin, he's provided some of their only sparks tonight. Trying to get something lit here as well. He's got another nice return as he's run out of bounds on the far sideline after a 25-yard run back. Georgia, we talked about the guys that are no longer here. Rashawn Ealy transferred. Caleb King, academically ineligible, went to the supplemental draft and starred for the Vikings the other night in their preseason game. And Carlton Thomas suspended for this one game. So they came in with a true freshman, Isaiah Crowell, who showed up pretty well, and Richard Samuel, a converted former tailback turned linebacker turned tailback again. So that was one of the tough spots. They only really have two backs tonight. And even though Samuel's been hobbled at times, he's back out there trying to block for Murray on this first down pass. Deep down the middle, incomplete. Tavares King, the closest guy, but George Iloka, the safety, is all over it.
No, I would say that the issue rests a little bit more with the Georgia offensive line than the backs that are here or not here. You know, last year they ran for 143 yards a game. That was 73rd in the nation. If you want to win in the SEC, you've got to run the football a little bit better. And Georgia has such a rich history and tradition of being able to run the football.
Yep.
Yeah, they're a little bit decimated at that position right now, but offensive line-wise, they had their hands full tonight with this Boise State front four.
Murray Byers completes. And that was Malcolm Mitchell, a true freshman. Coming up next, Sports Center will follow us. All the scores and highlights from college football. And we're done here. Center currently on ESPN News. There's the loss of a lineman. Canarius Gates, one of the starters who was shaken up tonight for Georgia. Murray fires complete. Nice throw. Heck of a catch by Antavius Wooten. He had a guy draped all over him and still made the grab. Pick up a 14. Aaron Murray, a touchdown and 144 yards, but an interception that was really costly late in the second quarter that led to a Bronco touchdown going in before the half.
If you're Georgia here, I mean, you don't give up on this. And even if some of the fans or a lot of the fans decide to leave and go on with the rest of their evening, you still have work to do here if you're the Bulldogs.
Murray trying to work it deep middle. What a strike! You're right, touchdown! Malcolm Mitchell. Not over yet. That was a laser shot to Mitchell, the freshman.
Murray's going to hang in there under pressure, and Malcolm Mitchell has great speed. Aaron Murray said, I can throw it as far as I want to this guy, and I'm not going to outthrow him. And that was a beautiful throw by Murray for the touchdown.
69 yards in a hurry. The capper, the Malcolm Mitchell for Murray. So there's still life in the Georgia Dome with the Dogs. They cut the deficit down to 35-21.
At Hampton, we love having you here. And in part by Hyundai. If it's fuel efficient, affordable, stylish, and safe, it's probably a Hyundai.
Well, about 4 seconds after my partner said that Georgia's got to keep grinding, Aaron Murray hit Malcolm Mitchell for a 51-yard touchdown, 35-21. Georgia, so many times last year, in their seven losses, they were in it in the fourth quarter and couldn't finish the drill, as they used to say around Athens. They got a lot of drilling left to do, but yeah, there's still hope.
Still a lot of work to do. And right now, their defense has got to step up. They've got to tackle the backs, anticipating Boise State's going to want to run to get some clock. And I think they got to go after Kellen Moore.
Walsh, the kick is deep. That'll help their cause. Bobble in the end zone, so there's not going to be a return by Martin. And that'll put Boise State at the 20-yard line, where Kellen Moore takes over.
Kellen Moore has thrown three touchdown passes tonight, and he's had a pretty clean night in the pocket. 25 of 30. He hasn't been sacked yet. The one time that Georgia got pressure on him, he threw an interception, but for the most part, he's been spotless. And I just think Georgia now has to say, you know what? We're going to have to just guard these guys man-to-man, and if they throw, we got to go after this quarterback and see if we can make him make a mistake, because it hasn't worked giving him time.
Let's see what happens from the 20. 10-15 to play in the fourth quarter. Play action for Moore. They do bring some heat, but it's a middle toss to Martin, and he spins for a first down and a bunch more.
Now Brent Peace is just one step ahead. I mean, you know, that's a perfect call. Georgia says, hey, we're going to dial it up. We're going to come after him. So he anticipates that. He draws the rush in, and he throws a middle screen. Brent Peace said, you know, I asked him, I said, what's your signature going to be on this offense? Your little fingerprint. He says, I don't know. He says, I've always been a little bit more of a screen guy than the guys before me. Well,
17 yards later.
Yeah.
It's a first down at the 36. Georgia again try to bring some pressure. This time a run blitz, and Martin's got three more. John Jenkins, the nose tackle, made the stop.
See, Boise wants to run the football and use as much clock as they can right now. There's 9.5 minutes left in the game, and they've got a two-score lead. So Kellen Moore's not going to be in any hurry right now. They're not going to get complacent, and I don't think you'll see him get ultra-conservative, but they're going to use as much clock as they possibly can in between plays.
Total yardage a little bit deceiving when you look at the scoreboard. It's close, but the scoreboard's still a two-touchdown difference. Second down and 7. Moore wants a quick slant. He got it and complete for a first down to Matt Miller, who had the first touchdown of the night for the Broncos.
Kellen Moore is accurate even when he doesn't set his feet. I mean, he threw that thing back and up. He never stopped and set his feet. He just kind of jumped and threw it, and you can't throw it any better than he did.
Certainly nothing imposing about him when you see him without the pads. He looks like he could do a remake of Leave It to Beaver or something, but right now he's chewing through the Georgia defense here in this fourth quarter. Ooh, almost another face mask penalty, but nice tough run on the inside for 8 yards for Martin.
You know, you use the word tough and a tough run. That's what I'm most impressed with about this team. They are a tough football team.
Yeah.
I mean, they're tough on their offensive defensive line. Doug Martin is a tough runner. Kellen Moore is a mentally and physically tough quarterback. I mean, they are a tough football team. They're not as big or as fast as some of these other major college powers, but I'll guarantee you they're every bit as tough as anybody in college football.
Second down at 2, under 8 minutes to play. Georgia needs to stop there, and they got it on Martin. No gain on the play. You know what, Boise State, if they win this game, they're going to become the Georgia Bulldogs' biggest fans the rest of the year. They'd love to see the Dogs run the table, because Baylor beat TCU. TCU's the toughest team, or supposedly were going to be a ranked tough team on their schedule down the line. They'd like to keep going up in the rankings, not backwards. Big third down. Can Georgia come up? As Todd said a couple of minutes ago, they need to step up to the plates.
You see Kellen Moore keeping that team in the huddle until the play clock is under 10.
Here's a toss. And Georgia come up with a stop. Martin, he got it. Nice run. He put a stiff arm out there to give himself a little breathing room. And he dives over that marker for the first down.
They stayed in the huddle a long time, then they came up to the line and quick snapped it, and Martin was able to get to the edge and get the tough first down.
He actually didn't get anything on that stiff arm, but he got an arm out there, and the Georgia tackler couldn't reach him. And now an all-important first down, and after an entire night of no huddles, as Todd said, smart quarterback, smart team, using all of the huddle and the clock that they can with a two-touchdown advantage. And now Kellen Moore's going to call a timeout.
Timeout. Boise State.
But you look at the teams that they have to play, ranked teams all the way along the list. Now Oregon still trying to hang in there with LSU, but if LSU wins that, Oregon is probably out of the national championship picture. With all that in mind, here's TCU leading an SEC team in an SEC backyard. Boise State leading Georgia by 2 touchdowns. And Todd, that always is going to bring up the conversation about, okay, could they do this every week if they played in the SEC, meaning Boise State?
Yeah, I don't know if you can answer that question, because to play in the SEC week in, week out, you need depth. And the simple reality is Boise doesn't have the same quality or level of depth that the top upper-level SEC teams do. But in terms of can they line up and play physically with anybody in this league on any given Saturday, absolutely.
Yeah.
And I'm talking about Alabama, LSU, Florida. I don't care who you line them up against. Because tonight, they've been the physically superior team over Georgia.
Here's a screen again to Martin. Gonna get blasted from behind by Garrison Smith, but a pickup of about 6. And again, as I said a couple of minutes ago, it isn't going to help Boise State's cause too much, even though they're ranked number 5 and they're impressive tonight. They don't have anybody left on their schedule once the BCS comes out the first week of October to boost them up there. Remember, they got as high as number 3 in the BCS last year. By the time they played Nevada and lost in overtime, they were down to 4. So they went backwards, actually. But this is a great way to start the season if you're planning on trying to run the table and win a national title. They got a 5-minute drive going, too, when Georgia needs the ball back and can't get it. But they need a stop on 3rd and 10, or the lights are going to be out here. Georgia loads up everybody in the middle. And here they come. The pass is incomplete. So finally, the clock stops.
Well, and Kellen Moore says, you know what? We didn't need points here. We did what we wanted to do, stay in the huddle and eat clock. And as you mentioned it, 5-minute drive, no points to show for it, but Georgia needs to score 2 touchdowns. So we did our job on offense by cutting the time in half.
And Elkins did a nice job of that rugby-style punt of keeping it out of the hands of number 1. Brandon Smith counting his troops in front of him, but he'd like to get his hands on a punt return and maybe make some electricity like Brandon Boykin did early in the ball game. This time he's just going to get rid of the kick, and it's going to be a fair catch inside the 10. So nice punt. Georgia is 90 plus yards away, and they need 2 touchdowns. Don't forget, American League Central rivals, the White Sox and the Tigers, get together on ESPN2 Sunday Night Baseball, presented by Taco Bell, part of the hunt for October, 8 o'clock Eastern tomorrow night.
Well, partner, there was an SEC team earlier today that was 10 points down with about 4 minutes and some change.
Yeah.
Team that happened to win the national championship last year that scored, recovered an onside kick, and scored again to win.
They did it on the plains. Can they do it here in the Dome?
Well, Utah State, not quite as strong an opponent, I don't think, as Boise State.
This is the worst starting field position at the worst time for Aaron Murray and Georgia at their own 9-yard line. He hooked up with Malcolm Mitchell for a 51-yard touchdown the last time they fired one. This time, it's complete to Malcolm Mitchell. Got to hustle. Everything's got to be quick now for Georgia. Should they be able to somehow get a touchdown, you'd think, as Todd said, much like Auburn, there'd be an onside kick, and maybe we would have a fantastic finish.
Well, you'd have to onside kick if you score, because Boise just proved they can eat 5 minutes off the clock.
Without even trying, almost. Now everybody's standing up for the Broncos. They don't even have a guy with a hand down. Murray fires complete. Now you want to get what you can and get out of bounds, although Samuel has it stripped from him, but he did get decent yardage after the catch. Pick up a 19, and that's Richard Samuel's best play of the night. So Crowell comes in to take his spot.
And again, if you're Aaron Murray, you better make sure Isaiah knows his blocking assignment in these pass situations. Boise State's only going to rush 4.
Crowell now an end around coming to Mitchell. Looking for a block. Got the corner. Mitchell gets across midfield. He's down to the 47-yard line. First down. 17-yard end around. So number 26, a true freshman from Valdosta, showing up well here.